Experiment 8 deals with the gas laws. Let's have a look at the Prelab review page. Question number 1 deals with specific safety alerts. You'll want to look for the triangle icons. Number 2, are there any disposal directions? Well, there isn't much space under number 2, and I think that's your clue that there are none given in this experiment. The rest of these questions are pretty straightforward. I've given you some tips on number 11. It says, what are the identities and sources of the two gases you will allow to diffuse in part C of the experiment? Well, the two gases are HCl and ammonia. HCl from concentrated HCl solution and ammonia from concentrated aqueous ammonia. And here are the data and report pages now. In part A, we look at Boyle's Law, and you'll be gathering volume data. The test tube volume data, first of all, because you're using a graduated cylinder, you'd want to record to the tenth. The barometric pressure will be given to you, and again, you'll want to record it to the tenth. And then finally, the test tube water height will record to the tenth. And the same is true of all the readings in this first table. You'll want to record everything to the tenth. In table 8.2, you're gathering, you're gathering more data, but this is the report part. The first column is the volume of the test tube. Want to make sure that all these values are recorded to the tenth. And it seems a little bit strange to a student, perhaps, that all the values in this column will be the same. So don't let that confuse you. The same is true in this second column. All the values will be the same. Then finally, when you calculate the volume over here in the fourth column, you'll use this formula up at the top. The test tube volume minus the water volume that's added plus the volume in the syringe is equal to V over here in the fourth column. And you'll want to make sure that you record all of those to the tenth. Table 8.3, here we need the barometric pressure. All the values will be the same in this first column. The net water height, you'll gather that data, and then you'll convert that data into the equivalent in centimeters of mercury in the third column. Then finally, the fourth column is your goal, and it's equal, this P in the fourth column is equal to the barometric pressure plus the net water height, the mercury equivalent, this PW right here. So it's PB plus PW is equal to P. And you want to make sure that your answer is expressed to three significant figures. Table 8.4, gathering data on pressure and volume. You'll multiply those two together. And when you get the product, you'll find that the answer is over 1,000. In other words, there are at least 4 digits in the answer and probably more. And because each of these components are to 3 significant figures, you want to express your answer as 3 significant figures. The only way you can do that is to use scientific notation. So that's really a big tip for you there. Part B deals with Charles Law. You'll gather temperatures, express those to the tenth. You'll be measuring sample volumes again, and express those to the tenth. Then in the report part of this, here's where you'll enter the temperatures, the volumes, then the sample temperature in kelvins, and finally, the K prime value, the constant value that you calculate. Want to make sure that it's to two significant figures. You could use scientific notation over here if you'd like, or use the regular form, but two significant figures. And down here is a very important part of your data, the absolute zero value from the graph that we'll look at in just a second. You know that absolute zero is 0K, but the value that you calculate may not be 0K, 0 kelvins. And this is how the grader knows whether you're fudging or not. If you put down 0 kelvins, chances are you've fudged your data. Here's the graph where you'll calculate K. And the horizontal axis is the sample volume. The vertical axis is the temperature. Theoretically, when the sample volume reaches zero, you're at absolute zero as well on this scale. And what you'll find is that when you plot these values of temperature versus volume, you get a number of points. You can draw a straight line. And where that straight line intersects the vertical column, the vertical axis, that's where you'll determine your value of absolute zero. Part C deals with Graham's law. And you'll be calculating the molecular weight of HCl. You use the periodic table to do that. Same thing here with ammonia. Use the periodic table. These two distances you'll get from the photographs right here in this data. And when you calculate the rate ratio, the experimental value, it'll be based upon these distances. The experimental rate ratio is equal to the distance of A over the distance of B, or in other words, ammonia over HCl. And the theoretical is a little bit different. Here you've got to use a little bit of math because it's the square root of the molecular weight of B over the molecular weight of A. And now the questions at the end. Pretty straightforward. They'll cause you a little challenge, but not too bad. I'll give you a tip for number three. The answer is C, and I'd like you to explain why. That completes the experiment. I hope you enjoy it. Remember to send me an email if I can be of help.